Welcome to Edurific. Hi students, in the previous session, we have acquainted ourselves with the artist lab a bit. To further understand the artist lab, we shall create a very simple project using some significant blocks. As you can see, we are already on the artist lab page of code.org platform. And in this session, we shall create a simple project of drawing a square. Now, I've already saved my project as square. Firstly, as you know, let's recall. Square is a shape which has four sides and all the four sides are equal of length and the angle between each side to the other side is 90 degrees. So, a square is totally a shape which has four sides, all four sides being equal and the angle between any two sides is 90 degrees. With this objective, we shall begin drawing a square. Firstly, as you can see in the visualizing session, if you observe, there is a small character. This character is the artist who shall draw whatever you instruct him with blocks that you assemble in the workspace. Basically, the blocks which you draw and drag into the workspace, creating a script by assembling them, give the instruction to this artist, indirectly the computer, to draw or shape whatever you have instructed. So, we shall go to the brushes firstly and choose our favorite color. So, in the brushes category, I will drag this command and assemble it. I will keep the color as it is in the red. Now we shall start drawing a square which by first we will choose which side to draw. So now we have to choose the length of the square. Let the length of the square be 100 units. How do we specify 100 units? For specifying 100 units, we shall go to the action section, drag the move forward command and assemble it. So basically, if you've seen, there is a small red dot that appears here. So our brush is now in action. Now we should make the brush, that is the artist, move forward by 100 units because that is the length of our square. So here in the place of question mark, we shall be adding 100. 100 pixels is nothing but the unit that the artist will move. So if you have seen, I'll run the code and below the code is a small turtle and a cheetah symbol. So since a turtle walks slowly and a cheetah is the fastest animal, the mode of the speed of our program can be adjusted accordingly. If we just slide it towards the turtle and run the code again, you will see that it has become slower. If you adjust it towards the cheetah, you will see that the code is super fast. So we can just place it in the middle and now reset it. As you've seen, one side of the square is thus created. What do we do to create the second side? So our artist has reached the end of the first side of the square. For the second side, which makes an angle 90 degrees with the first side, as we have already discussed that an angle between two sides in a square is 90 degrees, we have to first make the artist move 90 degrees downwards. How do we do that? So, for making the artist move downwards, we have to turn him right from the current position. That is, the artist should turn towards the right direction from the current position. For moving the artist from the current position to the right direction, we again have to go to the actions category, drag the command turn right as you can see, there is again a degrees that is should be specified, and as we know, the degrees between, which is the angle between two sides of a square, is 90 degrees. We shall place 90. And if you can see, there is a visualizing box which already has shown the direction in which the artist is likely to move. In case, if we'll place it right to left and place our degrees, you can see again the visualizing box has shown that the artist shall move upwards and 90 degrees. So this is not the case. You can move it up or down, anything will form a square. So let us try by taking left itself. Now, since the artist has now moved left and 90 degrees, we have to make the second side. How do we make the second side? We have to make the second side of the equal length of the first side, which is 100 units. So for that, again, we shall go to the actions category, drag the move forward command, assemble it in the script, and again, since all the sides of a square are equal, we shall again place 100 units. As you can see, the second side of the square is thus formed. We shall run our code. Yes. Now the third and fourth sides are left. How do we do this? Yes, we will follow the same method. Now from this point where the artist has reached the end of the second side, we have to again turn 90 degrees. Since again, the angle between the second side and the third side is 90 degrees. For this, again, we shall go to the action section, drag the turn right command or directly the turn left command, and if you have seen, this is not the direction which we require. So for that, we shall again change right to left, and before actually adding the code, we can just check it. So if you have seen, yes, this is the direction which we need to move to. So in the visualizing section, if you can see, the artist has already turned towards the left and is ready to move. So for the third side, which is also equal to the first and the second side, the length should be equal to 100 units or pixels. For again making the third side, we should go to the actions category, drag the move forward command, and can you tell me what can be the number of pixels that we should be entering? Yes, it is 100 because a square has equal sides. Now as you can see, our third side is thus made. We are just now left with the fourth side. How do we do the fourth side? Yes, it's the same thing again, which we'll be repeating. So for the fourth side, we'll again repeat the steps that we have done for the first, second and third side. That is, now first we will change the direction of the artist and the angle to 90 degrees, since again, the angle between the third and the fourth side is 90 degrees. So for this, we shall directly take the turn left command, place it here, and can you tell me what should be typed in place for degrees? Yes, exactly, it is 90 degrees. As you can see, as you keep on changing the commands and the entries, the artist moves accordingly. So the artist is ready to draw a line downwards. So how do we draw the fourth line? Yes, we shall repeat the same steps which we have done for the first, second and third line. That is, we shall go to actions, drag the move forward command, and can you tell me what should be placed here? Yes, it is 100 because all the four sides of a triangle are equal and so is the fourth side. As you can see, the artist has already drawn the last side, that is the fourth side. And if you can see properly, a square is thus formed. So I shall reset it and compile the code. Compiling the code is nothing but running the script or the code which we have run in the workspace. So I shall press run. Yes, it has drawn all the four sides forming a square. So isn't it nice to actually draw a square without actually drawing it with the help of a code? So that's how we have created a square, and that's how we have created our first project on the Artist Lab. I hope you are familiarized with the different categories like brushes, actions, and the artist in the visualizing section by now. But have you noticed something? Don't you think all these commands, move forward by 100 pixels, turn left by 90 degrees, again, move forward by 100 pixels, turn left by 90 degrees, are very repetitive? That is, we are adding again and again the same command to form a square. Is there any simple way or a way in which lesser number of steps can be added or assembled and our result is the same? Can you think of something? Yes, there is a very sophisticated way of creating a square without actually placing all of these commands again and again, becoming a repetitive script. Instead, we shall create a sophisticated code with less number of steps but giving us the same result of creating a square. So for this, I have again going to a new artist page on the code.org platform itself. This I shall rename as Simple Square, because instead of using all the different commands again and again, we will use very simple commands and form a very small code for the same result, which is of creating a square using the artist which is already present in the visualizing section. How do we do this? So we will explore some categories which we haven't explored yet. So for this, we shall go to the functions category. Here you can see different commands like draw a circle, draw a house, draw a pinwheel, draw a shape, draw a square. And if you scroll down, you can see draw a star, draw a triangle. Now, all these functions, when used or assembled in the script, directly draw the shape which we require. So, since the shape which we require is a square, I shall drag this command and place it in the workspace, assembling it in the script. As you can see, now it is said that when the run button is pressed, that is when the code is compiled, we should draw a square. But something is missing, isn't it? Yes, exactly. In the previous section, as you can see, our square is formed of 100 pixels or units. Now we have to specify here the length of each side of the square so that the artist will be able to draw the square according to the prescribed length. So how do we specify the length? For this, again we shall go to a category which we haven't explored before, which is the math category. In the math category, if you can spot, there is a command with a number entry, that is, a number can be the entry of that command. So we shall drag this command and we shall attach it in the cavity. So as you can see, now for the length, we should specify the number that we want, which should be the length of the side of the square. So going back to the previous one, as we have specified that the length of the square should be 100 units or 100 pixels, that is what we shall be doing here. So I shall change from 0 to 100. As you can see on the visualizing section, as soon as I've changed it to 100, the artist has drawn a square. I shall now run the code. Yes, so our square is thus created, but in black color. So if you want to change the brush, we can again drag the set color, place it, and reset it. Why do you think hasn't the color changed? So we shall have to drag this out, place the set color in between, and then now we shall see. So yes, our square is thus formed. Except for that, we have taken a left command here, whereas here it has already been induced to take the right. So our square is just a bit below than in the previous section. However, if you've noticed, the number of commands were about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There were 9 commands in the first, where some of the commands were very repetitive for the same function. Whereas in the second project, which we have created for a simple square, the 9 commands have been reduced to 1, 2 and 3 commands, which by thus is creating a simple and a very sophisticated code with giving us the same result of forming a square. I hope you have understood how to use the Artist Lab by now and create a simple project of a small square or a triangle or a circle by using the functions category. Thank you.